Hey there, Gemini, Sun, Moon, and Rising. It's time to have a look and see what is going on when it comes to your tarot for the month of October 2021. And yes, you do have a monthly astrology report. It's up. You can check it out on my main channel page. Just click on my avatar below and it'll take you to all of the playlists and you can just, you know, scroll down and have a look, see what's going on there. And also, don't forget, if you ever want to get a session with me, all you need to do is go on ahead to my website. It's integrativemysticism.com. So, what is going on when it comes to your month? We're going to start on the right-hand side and look at the big themes. And we're going to look at the top row first, seeing what's going on with you and, you know, just your story. And you've got the Hangman upright and the Knight of Wands upright as far as what's going on with you and your world. And it's kind of interesting because it feels like a lot of you Gemini people are ultimately being carried. And when I say being carried, I don't mean like, you know, being carried by other people or, you know, being dragged around or anything like that. But a lot of this month, you're going to be noticing your environmental circumstances going through some major transitions in a very positive way, where a lot of your own routines, a lot of your own normals, a lot of your own staples will have to be suspended, will have to chill for a bit, right, with the Hangman, because you're adapting to a completely new way the world is run around you. And this is happening because the Knight of Wands is coming in and accelerating a lot of your growth, bringing in a big push that is ultimately transforming a lot of the tools and processes and procedures that you are working with. You are also going to be finding that a lot of this month is going very, very hard to initiate a lot of maybe adventures or a lot of aspirations, a lot of goals that you have had left on the shelf, or maybe you have not thought to enact or commence with yourself. And with the Hangman, what's happening here is that a lot of this is taking over the life you've been working on, maybe, you know, this last few months or even the last few years. The good news is that, I mean, that's also good news, but with the Hangman, though, what I'm also seeing is that a lot of this is very gratifying. A lot of this is actually bringing in a lot more spiritual, social, creative, and financial stimulation to a lot of you. And so it's almost like you're hanging up one aspect of your life or one chapter in your life that you are kind of done with. It's not really something that you have to finish, and you're taking on a lot of these new stimuli. You're able to sort of, it's almost like walking into a parallel reality where you are able to feel that dynamism, feel that excitement, feel that creativity, feel that abundance, feel that inspiration. In fact, with the Knight of Wands, you're going to be noticing that a lot of things that you have been working on that maybe have been small or starting small are starting to expand, starting to become a lot more powerful. Maybe, yes, a bit more demanding, but in a very good way, because they're also gratifying. They're paying off. They're paying you out. And we're focusing a lot more on you this month. You are dropping a lot of things that maybe you've been carrying for other people or worlds or realities or, you know, even life circumstances you've been carrying for other people. And a big part of that is illustrated in our next two cards, the bottom line and the culmination of the month, or the big story of the month, with the World card reversed and the Queen of Cups reversed. This whole month is giving you a chance to be a lot more inwardly focused, because you're getting a lot of chances to do over entire eras of your life. The World card reversed always gives us an opportunity for do-overs. And if there are things that you wish you could have started again, or things that you wish you maybe would like to do for a better result this time around than it was before, or with the World card reversed, even getting a chance to pick up things that ultimately were forced to wait on standby to external circumstances. This is the month where you're going to get your shot. Because with the Queen of Cups reversed, the big story of this month is letting go of living lives that are not yours. Because of the Queen of Cups reversed, you are going to be facing a lot of challenges this month where you're kind of noticing that you've been taking on a lot of responsibilities or maybe even incurring a lot of costs, material costs, social costs, spiritual costs, time costs, for other people's narratives or for other people's whatevers. Because with the Queen of Cups reversed, we're definitely doing a lot of purging of a lot of coasting, or a lot of coasters, a lot of leeches, so to speak, a lot of influences that have ultimately been forcing us to kind of maybe run their life, hold up their life, hold up their project, hold up their story at our own expense, and at the expense of us not getting to live our own lives. This is a month where that whole circumstance gets to pivot. You don't have to do that. You're not beholden to that anymore. And with the World card reversed and that Knight of Wands, you're also having a lot of your own opportunities, a lot of your money, a lot of your resources, a lot of your time come back to you to be reinvested in you and to do with as you choose. When it comes to your material circumstances, your job, your finances, living situation, your career, you do have the Two of Pentacles upright. And this is going to be a fairly hectic month, and in a very good way. I am actually seeing this as one where a lot of you Gemini people could be making a fair amount of money fairly quickly. But you are going to be finding that you are approaching a crossroads fast, and this has to do with possibly one or two new career opportunities or jobs or financial or even living situation directions you could take need you to, at some point this month, you know, arrive at a conclusion of which path you're going to choose. Because with the Two of Pentacles, I'm seeing you sort of living in two different places at once, working in two places at once. And while it is very rewarding, it's not something that is sustainable. This can also show up for new job opportunities where we are going to have to make up our minds at the beginning, or not at the beginning, sorry, at some point. But in the beginning, we can absolutely weigh our options. But you are going to want to stay invested, stay involved. You don't want to necessarily be too passive with the opportunities that are coming your way. A lot of you are also going to find that because things are so busy and paying out, you are getting a chance to also invest a bit more into something that ultimately you have not been giving yourself the chance to spend any time with. And this could be a major purchase. This could be something that you're trying to change for yourself or for your family, or maybe even something that you are trying to bring online or bring back online as per that World card reversed. It's a very, very nice month, but at some point you're going to have to make a commitment because you're not going to be able to maintain this pace of, again, being in two places at the same time, juggling too many priorities at once, living a double life financially, professionally. It's not sustainable. But you know what? It's a great time for catching up with yourself. It's a great time for getting ahead. When it comes to your community, friends, relatives, other people in your life, you do have the Knight of Swords reversed. There could be a falling out or two this month. With the Knight of Swords reversed, there could be some battles that end up coming to a head. And this is talking about the platonic world, right? So family or the guys, the girls. It's not so much a romantic card. And with the Knight of Swords reversed, this has to do with somebody overstepping their bounds, overstepping and possibly even creating problems for you by actively or passively starting conflicts with other people or other priorities that you have in your life. The Knight of Swords reversed is an aggressor. They are the aggressor in this situation. So this may even come in the form of an attack or a deliberate effort to undermine or to damage in some way. And I'm seeing this as something where it's like, yeah, the call is coming from inside the house, Gemini. This is somebody within the crew. This is somebody within the circle or within the family. And this is something that's going to have to be, you know, stamped out. When it comes to your challenge for this month, we do have the Strength card reversed, really needing to pay attention to where certain hungers, certain thirsts, certain needs are not getting sated. And what can we do to bring that back into balance? Because I'm seeing with the Strength card reversed is your challenge is to get over a self-imposed lack, a self-imposed block, a self-denial, if you will. Something that you maybe have been holding from yourself or something that you have been not allowing yourself to enjoy, explore, or maybe, you know, even nourish yourself with needs to come into your life, needs to be a part of your life. You know, have you gone way too long without playing music, but you're a musician? Have you gone way too long without maybe a certain type of social experience, travel experience? Is there something going on with your own body, with your own needs, your own physical needs? Is there something going on with your home life? What has been lacking that's been sort of an acceptable loss or an acceptable lack that needs to get reversed? You're challenged with figuring that out and solving that this month. It'd be great if you could do it this week, but this month. When it comes to love and romance and partnerships, you got the Ten of Pentacles upright. And this month is going to be beautiful when it comes to love, because it does look like when it comes to partnerships are starting to move in a direction where they are ready to set up a completely new home territory, a new home base, a new sense of sanctuary that is, it's just fulfilling every need on all levels. With the Ten of Pentacles, this could be a time where a lot of you and partners are getting ready for some kind of big move. There could be some brilliant news coming from a partner about a big material win on their part, or something that's coming in through their family or through their business or through their job that is allowing all of you to actually physicalize an aspiration that has been made to wait, something that is going to provide a great deal of security, a great deal of wealth. It's wonderful. It's absolutely gorgeous. And a lot of you who are single, available, or maybe you've been interacting with somebody recently are also going to find that there are a lot of boosts for you and your intended, which is also allowing you to pursue this relationship in a much more comfortable way. I do feel that this could be maybe the substantiation of a chemistry, again, if it's recent, or maybe even somebody new, if you're meeting them this month, that is heading in the same direction as you. And there may be something that comes this month that allows that to be realized, something that is going to push this forth into being. This connection, this chemistry has the potential for great longevity because everyone is so deeply connected on a much more intimate level as far as their sensibilities are concerned, you know, tastes, desires, what they feel makes a happy, healthy home, happy, healthy family, all of that clicks. And that's going to be something that clicks for all of you in love. When it comes to your month in terms of beginning to end, we start the month off with the Five of Wands upright, crossed with the Ten of Swords reversed. And I'm actually seeing a very positive shift create a lot of discord, create a lot of chaos for you. And this has to do with a big break in the form of you being able to recover something or finally embark on something, a journey, a quest that you've desired. Right, with the Ten of Swords reversed, something is coming back online, or something is finally having its chance after being blocked or denied, but it is disrupting the status quo with the Five of Wands upright. It's really competing with a lot of other balls you've had up in the air. And it might throw things into a bit of chaos for the first half of the month. And what brings this about is the Ace of Pentacles upright and the Three of Cups reversed. A big break in the form of the Ace of Pentacles is allowing you to step into a space where you can raise your standards across the board. You know, you're elevating your status, you're elevating your station. There is a new road that is finally getting set, or a new opportunity, a new venture that is finally being embarked upon that is already paying for itself and paying more. Maybe it's paying financially, because we do see a lot of that coming your way this month, but this could also be something that is paying out in other ways. But with the Three of Cups reversed, what is happening here is that it could create a bit of a cultural clash as far as what you have been working with so far, maybe at the office, maybe among your friendship circles, maybe even with the environment that you are in, just as a location in general. This will need to be fixed, or if it can't be fixed, sorted. When it comes to the second half of the month, a lot of you are really pulling back a lot of involvements that you've maintained that you have no business holding on to anymore. I'm seeing with the Seven of Wands reversed, there is going to be a need to choose your battles, especially when it comes to things that don't need to be fought anymore and don't need to be fought for anymore. This could be because of that Knight of Swords reversed or the Queen of Cups reversed. There's something going on here where you're going to need to let somebody kind of, sleep in the bed they made for themselves. And with the Tower card reversed, this could get ugly for them. But it's important to understand that you've been holding back the tide for so long. Maybe you've been denying this person the opportunity to maybe learn a lesson or two, right? If a person cheats and borrows answers every single second or every single time they need some assistance or they need something from the universe, eventually the universe is going to put them through a test. We're doing them no favors by protecting them from the test. And a lot of you may have to just let something fall down that you were the only one keeping up and it wasn't even for you. So that's what I've got for you, Gemini. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I appreciate it. And should you ever want to get a session with me, go on ahead to my website. It's integrativemysticism.com.